Today, Senator Kamala Harris returning to the all-important state of Iowa tomorrow. And one topic that's following her on the campaign trail is her record as a prosecutor. This is a decision she made as a young district attorney, and it could well come back to haunt her. Kyung La is out front.
This is my little girl.
Isaac Espinosa.
Yay!
Young father.
Come on, Daddy. There you go.
Devoted husband.
Daddy's
and San Francisco police officer until his end of watch, April 10th, 2004.
His captain comes over and I'm just sitting there and he hands me his star. I remember I walk into this room and he still had blood here. He was laying there with his eyes closed and I saw the blood here. And I walked over to him and I was just like, wake up.
Just 29. Espinosa was gunned down with an AK-47 by a 21-year-old gang member. A new district attorney had just been elected in San Francisco, Kamala Harris, her first elected position. 3 days after Officer Espinosa's death, Harris held a news conference pledging to keep a campaign promise, no death penalty.
In San Francisco, it is the will, I believe, of a majority of people that the most severe crimes be met with the most severe consequences, and that life without possibility of parole is a severe consequence.
I felt like she had just taken something from us. She had just taken justice from us, from Isaac.
Did she call you?
No, she never called me. I just don't understand how or why she would. You can't even wait till he's buried. You can't even wait to talk to the family. You can't just wait and, you know, have some compassion and check in on the family.
And I'm standing there and I'm going, oh my God.
Gary Delanis, the man standing next to Harris, was the president of the San Francisco Police Officers Association at the time.
You're thinking to yourself, okay, is she sorry that this kid died or is this just a political opportunity? Is this just an opportunity for her to double down on the fact she's not going to pursue the death penalty? What would her motives be to do this so soon after the death?
The political blowback for Harris was enormous. At Espinosa's funeral, as Harris sat in the pews, U.S. Senator Dianne Feinstein indirectly rebuked the new DA for not seeking the death penalty. The hundreds of officers gave Feinstein a standing ovation.
Do you give Harris any credit for sticking to her beliefs?
She was in a tough spot. I don't begrudge her that, but the way it was handled and the timing, it was just.
For you, this is not about the death penalty.
No.
In the months that followed, Renata Espinosa wrote Kamala Harris a letter. Years passed. The family says Harris never responded. They say they had only one face-to-face meeting with Harris, arranged by an assistant district attorney.
She never reached out to me, never came over and said, I'm sorry for your loss, nothing.
Why do you, as a victim of crime, need the district attorney to say those things?
Because it makes me feel like, okay, you honestly do care about what happens, you know? And not only that, but it shows that you're compassionate, you know, that you have feelings. It's losing somebody and having somebody that is gonna fight for justice come up to you and say, I'm sorry for your loss.
The fact that Officer Espinosa was killed in the line of duty is an absolute tragedy.
On the campaign trail, Harris would not answer why she did not personally reach out to the family, but says someone from her office did.
We reached out to the family. We always did, and we did in that case as well, and offered all of the support that our office was able to give the family.
And defended her handling of the case.
I did not ask for permission to make my decision.
Officer Espinosa's murderer, David Hill, was sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole.
Why is that important to know, as President of the United States, how she treated you?
You're going to be President of the United States. That's a lot. Are you going to show compassion? Are you going to be for the people? Are you going to be for yourself? Are you really being you?
Now to the San Francisco Chronicle, Senator Harris will say about her handling of the news conference in the Espinoza case, quote, maybe it was just a political novice mistake. Now, Senator Dianne Feinstein, Aaron, who delivered that public rebuke at the funeral, she would later reverse her position on the death penalty. She now no longer supports it like many progressive Democrats. Aaron.
All right. Thank you very much, Kyung. Of course, maybe it's not the policy, but the handling of the whole situation. We'll see how that story is perceived on the campaign.